हेलो फ्रेंड्स, इन द सीरीज ऑन द इनकम टैक्स केसेस टुडे वी विल डिस्कस ए वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इशू व्हेन द अपील इज पेंडिंग बिफोर द सीआईटी अपील्स। एज ऑल वी नो दैट नाउ इट इज ए लॉट ऑफ सीआईटी अपील ऑर्डर्स आर कमिंग विच आर एक्स पार्टी बिकॉज ऑफ द फैक्टर दैट एसएससी इज नॉट रिप्लाइंग टू द नोटिसेस एंड द सीआईटी अपील ऑर्डर्स आर पास्ड for non-prosecution. What is the reason of passing these ex parte orders? The main reason is that the notices are not being served on the assessee properly. Although it is not always the case, sometimes the assessee is also unresponsive, but the major issue is that the service of the notice. The same issue comes when the assessment orders are passed under section 147 or 143 because the notices are not being served. Nowadays the notices are served through email, they are not served through speed post, due to which the assessee is not able to receive the notices on time and to give the submissions on time. That is why even the assessment orders are ex parte, and in some cases even the CIT appeals are ex parte. The issue which came before the tribunal in the present case is that whether the CIT appeal has the power to pass the ex parte order for non-prosecution. That is, whether the CIT appeal has the power to pass the ex parte order in case when the assessee does not give submissions to the CIT appeal. This issue has been taken up by the Ahmedabad ITAT B bench in the case of Babu Bhai Raman Bhai Patel versus Deputy Commissioner of Income Tax and another. This issue has been reported in 110 ITR, Tribunal Short Notes 39, and the date of the judgment is 15th February 2024. Section 250 talks about the procedure in appeal. Section 250 subsection 4 says that the CIT appeal has the power to make further inquiry as he deems fit for passing his order, or the CIT appeal has the power to conduct that inquiry through the assessing officer and direct him to give the results of that inquiry to the CIT appeal. Section 250 subsection 5 says that the CIT appeal has the power to entertain those grounds which the assessee has not taken at the time of filing the appeal. That is, the grounds which the assessee has not taken in the appeal form, but those grounds which the assessee takes at the time of submissions to the CIT appeal or at the time of the hearing. If the assessee proves that this non-submission of the grounds at the time of filing the forms is not willful or unreasonable, meaning thereby that if the CIT appeal feels that there are not some grounds which are in the appeal form, but at the time of submissions the assessee is pressing those grounds, then the CIT appeal has the power to entertain those grounds. Now section 250 subsection 6 says that when the CIT appeal order is being passed, he has to state the point of determination, the decisions thereof, and the reasons for the decision of the CIT appeal. Meaning thereby that in any case, if any order is passed by the CIT appeal, that order should be speaking order, and in nutshell, it can be concluded that even if the assessee does not appear before the CIT appeal, then the CIT appeal do not have the power to dismiss the appeal of the assessee on the ground of non-prosecution, and the ex parte order cannot be passed by the CIT appeal. Whatever the information is available with the CIT appeal, whatever the grounds are available with the CIT appeal, and even the CIT appeal can go for the inquiry, so the CIT appeal cannot pass the ex parte order for non-prosecution. In the present case, the assessee has already applied for 2 dates adjournments, and the assessee has applied the 3rd adjournment. The COVID period was intervening, the adjournment was not allowed, and the ex parte order, non-speaking order was passed. Friends, in the present scenario, when the appeals are faceless, there is a major issue whether at the time of assessment or at the time of CIT appeal that the notices are not being properly served on the assessee and the assessment orders under section 147 and the appeals are decided on the basis of ex parte order and not on the basis of reasoning orders. This is the sole reason of the high litigation in the income tax proceedings. At the end of this video, once again I am repeating the name of the case. The name of the case is Babu Bhai Raman Bhai Patel versus Deputy Commissioner of Income Tax, and this case has been reported in 110 ITR Tribunal Short Notes 39. The date of the judgment is 15th February 2024. Thank you, friends.